Welcome to this brief guide on how to sync data between Google Sheets. Have you ever spent ages manually copying and pasting data between Google Sheets? It's frustrating, right? Well, get ready to ditch the hassle, because in this video, we're diving into the magic of syncing your Google Sheets. Imagine your spreadsheets working in harmony, updating automatically and saving you precious time and headaches. Whether you're a beginner or a spreadsheet ninja, this tutorial is for you. Let's get started. Our first, and honestly the biggest, hero is the IMPORTRANGE function. This function acts like a magical bridge, allowing you to pull data from one Google Sheet and display it in another. Here's why it's awesome. Imagine this, you update the original sheet, and like magic, the changes appear instantly in the second sheet. No more copying and pasting required. This is perfect for when multiple people will need access to the same live data. So how does it work? Well, firstly, we open our destination sheet. This is the sheet where we want the data to show up. Think of it as our display window. Then, choose the cell where you want the top left corner of your imported data to appear. Simply start typing in equals, import range, and an open parentheses, and you'll see Google Sheets will start suggesting the function for you. Now, in quotation marks, paste in the full web address of the sheet we're importing from. You can grab this from your browser's address bar. Don't forget to include the quotation marks. That is super important. Now, we need to specify the sheet and range. So after a comma, in quotation marks, type the exact name of the tab in your source sheet, like sheet 1, followed by an exclamation mark. And then the cell range where you want to import. For example, A1 to B10 would get you all the data from cell A1 through to cell B10. Remember those quotation marks. And now we close it all up. So finish the formula with a closing parenthesis and hit enter. Oh no, it looks like we have an issue. But this is actually expected the first time around. It's the last step of allowing access to the linked file. This is only required the first time you try to import. And presto, you should see the data magically appear in your destination sheet. Now, whenever you make changes in your source sheet, this sheet will update automatically. Some real-world examples of this could be a team project, where you have one sheet where team members update their progress, and a main project dashboard sheet that automatically pulls in those updates. Or maybe you want to set up separate sheets for different types of expenses for your budget, and then have a master budget sheet that imports and summarizes everything. But what if you only want part of the data from your source sheet to synchronize? That's where the query function steps in. It's like adding a filter to your data import. Maybe you have a huge data sheet, but you only need rows where a certain condition is met. Like maybe all of the sales team members from your company. Or perhaps you want to reorder the columns showing the most important information first. Query is your tool for customizing the imported data. Before we dive into the query formula though, we need to understand how to use select. Think of select as your shopping list. You tell query exactly what items or columns you want from the source sheet's data table. You can choose specific columns by name, for example, select column 1 and column 4, or just grab everything with an asterisk, so saying select asterisk. Remember, column names in Google Sheets are case sensitive, so col1 with an uppercase C is different from col1 with a lowercase c. If you want to change the order of the columns, just list them in the order you prefer in the select statement. Let's see this all in action. We'll need to enclose our entire import range function within query. This means that the query will take the imported data from import range and then manipulate it further. Inside the query function, you'll write your query starting with select. Here are a couple of examples. The first one is filtering by a condition. This formula imports all columns because it's using select asterisk, but only rows where the value in the fourth column, col 4, is exactly the word sales. And then for our second example, we want to select specific columns. So as you can see, this formula imports only the second, col 2, and the fourth, col 4, columns from the source sheet, ignoring the rest. An added benefit of this is the ability to dictate the order in which these columns will be displayed, allowing you to display more important details first if desired. You are completely in control. Be sure to experiment with different queries to filter, sort, and customize the data that gets imported into your sheet. Sometimes, though, you may want to keep related data in one sheet, but on different tabs. Well, no problem. You can easily sync the data between tabs using array formula. Here's how this works. In your destination tab, simply reference the cells from the source tab using the tab name and an exclamation point, like we did before. For example, equals array formula sheet 1 A1 to B10 will display the values from cell A1 through to B10 from sheet 1. You can even use regular formulas with these references. So you could do equals sum and parentheses put sheet 1 exclamation mark A1 to A10 to get the sum of a column from another tab. This method is super simple, but helps when you wish to keep everything neatly organized within the same workbook. Syncing is usually smooth sailing, but sometimes you might hit a snag. Here are some of the common issues and some quick tips on how to fix them. A ref error. This usually means the source sheet or cell range does not exist. Double check the URL, sheet name, and cell range in your import range formula. Permission issues. Make sure you have permission to access the source sheet. You may need to request access from the sheet owner. Slow updates. If your sheets are massive, syncing might take a while. Try either reducing the amount of data you're importing or consider using a third-party add-on for faster synchronization. Query errors. If your query isn't working, be sure to check your syntax carefully. The error message will usually give you a hint about exactly what's wrong. Remember, third-party Google Sheets add-ons can also potentially offer even more powerful syncing options. So explore those if you need even more advanced features. Congrats! You've now mastered the art of syncing Google Sheets. Remember, the best way to learn is by doing. So fire up those sheets and experiment with the different syncing methods and explore those powerful add-ons. If you have any questions or want to share how you are using this feature, be sure to drop a comment below. I'd love to hear from you. Happy syncing, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.